In this video, we'll be going over some common problems that can occur when changing attachments on your excavator if the necessary precautions aren't being performed correctly. If you want to see the step-by-step guide on how to properly change attachments, head over to Rent One, where we've partnered up to create a helpful video. The video will be linked in the description below. The first common problem is when you go to remove the lock pin and it is stuck or hard to get out.
First thing is to check whether the lock pin's loose. That means that generally everything is correctly fitting between the wedge coupler and the lugging on the bucket. Generally, when the lock pin will not come out, someone hasn't either done some homework or watched a video or asked someone an easy question. They've tripped the switch and they're out here trying to pull this out. And now you've got all that hydraulic force pushing on the wedge and you're asking your question, why won't it come out? In that case, what you can do is go back in the cab, trip the switch so that it reactivates the wedge coupler to go back into place and hold the bucket again. You can again come out and make sure that you're square to the ground. You can find yourself, oh, look, now it's loose. Now I can take it out. You definitely don't ever do this in the air. There could be people standing there. There could be other reasons why you don't ever want to have this pulled out while it's off the ground. Most, if not all, hydraulic couplers come with a locking pin, a manual locking pin. This lock pin must be installed at all times during operation of the machine, even though the hydraulics actually keep the bucket in place. The lock bar stops the wedge from coming back at all times. That way, if the switch is tripped or there is a hydraulic failure, this is actually a redundant piece, but must be in place at all times. So that way the double redundancy is there.
The lock pin and safety pin that keeps the lock pin in place is most commonly lost when it is removed without being connected together and stored in a safe place. Dave recommends always locking the two together and placing it in a place where you can always see it but not trip over. Another problem is damage to the wedge bar and bucket lugging if you do not wait the appropriate 15 to 20 second minimum when removing the attachment. Another common problem is trying to attach the bucket and not first ensuring that the wedge is fully disengaged. You will know it is fully disengaged by first visibly checking from your cab and by waiting a minimum of 15 to 20 seconds when hitting the disengaged switch. If you do not hear an audible cue that sounds like this, then the wedge is being engaged and not disengaging. Attempting to line up the second lugging when the wedge is not fully disengaged will cause damage to your machine.
You always want to ensure that 100% of contact has been made on the backside of the coupler with the wedge bar, okay, or you will not have a clearance here, and trying to do it too quickly, it's going to cause damage to this point on the bucket lugging, and it is going to cause damage to the wedge itself. Not doing that will cause a great amount of oil to be moving through the hydraulic cylinder, which can cause damage to the cylinder itself or blow a hydraulic hose.
And finally, it is recommended, especially for inexperienced operators, to turn down the RPM when changing attachments. And those are some of the most common problems that can occur when changing attachments on your excavator. Want to learn more about how to maintain your heavy equipment? Check out some of our other videos. If you're interested in renting this machine or anything else, visit rentone.ca if you're in Canada and rentoneusa.com if you're in the United States. Want a tutorial on anything else? Let us know in the comments.